This is how you park a dog.
And you give him a kibble. And it's not trained, it's negotiated behavior. Grunt, we're going to see Jeff Dunnum. Dun dun dun. Grunt doesn't even like comedy shows, but you're gonna like this one. It's gonna be great. Lady Janine with her racing gloves on. Are you excited, Janine?
Are you ready for me to speed up? Give you quite a thrill?
Speed limit around here is 40, Janine. You get a speeding ticket at 42. She's not thrilled about driving. Ever. Shaved for the occasion. It's been a long time since I've seen my face. A little scar here from ski racing. It looks like a knife wound. I was actually fixing it. I was doing these kind of adhesion type work and it was getting better. And I'm like, whoa, it's going to go away. And then I'm not going to have a cool story. Like I was skiing and broke my helmet, hit a snow gun. And then all I'm going to left with is these ones up and through. I don't even have wrinkles that I know of. I mean, these are from walking into walls, all very vertical, and happened over a couple weeks. It was horrible. It happens all the time. I can't believe how quick I bleed. Anyways, we're not talking about that. We're going to see Jeff Dunnum at Kitchener Odd. And I'm actually potentially going to wear a mask at times. Not sure how long I'm going to wear it and what it's for, but I think it's a good idea. You know, it's being recommended. But see, when I cough, I'm expelling water particles, and some of them may be infected. Now, I don't think I am, and I think my risk is fairly low, except for I do some activities, and now I'm going to be doing it in a high congregate setting, so there could be 5,000 people there. So I think here would be a good idea for everybody. I don't think it's going to protect me, but I think that if I wear a mask, I will help to protect the public. So I think as a general rule, and I know there's going to be people coughing and sneezing. Anyways, we've arrived to pick up our first guest of the evening.
You're kind of a backseat guy. Nobody wants to admit they're with you.
You're on candid camera, Mr. Mike.
All right.
Oh, actually, tonight we should just call you Mike then, right?
Well, you can call me Master.
Master Mike. Are you excited, Mike?
Sure.
I know you're a puppeteer.
Yeah.
You're not a ventriloquist though, are you?
No.
No. You don't mind if your lips are moving.
My lips are always flopping.
Mike's my blind buddy, and truthfully he's better blind than I am. I always said I was a poor choice and I'm a poor example, so but I do the best I can. And we're off! One more guest when we arrive and our party will be complete. Gromit's gonna enjoy a picnic dinner outside of the auditorium. It's 45 minutes early, but he's agreed that that would be acceptable, considering you're not allowed to take external food or drink in, so. Gotta fill up your belly. It's a tailgate party, woo! Gromit, no. Hey, hop up. Really windy out here, but you'll notice that my date, Janine, is with Michael. So it looks like I'm alone, except for with the dog, which is cool.
So are you holding on to you too?
Oh, that's okay. Then it looks like you're with a happy threesome, which is cool too. Everybody's congregating and getting together. We're all in excitement going up to the auditorium for Jeff Dunnum. Wow. Two blind guys just found each other. How'd you find them? Rod, I got you on my camera. Say hello.
Hello to who?
My camera? Well, it's nobody in particular, just Michael and I. Rod's going to be our fourth guest for this evening. Happy to have you. Whoa. Yeah, Gromit's going too fast. He's eager. He wants to go see those puppets.
Here, you'll come closer.
The two people that were on the floor were not able to join us, so we're trying to see if we can get all four people to be in one spot. And anywhere that three people could see would be wonderful.
Bring it down and you'll go in the next elevator. Okay?
Awesome. Thank you so much.
You're very welcome.
Somebody here is special. We've been recognized because we're going to get to take the elevator. It's probably Gromit. We're going to get to take the elevator to the penthouse. Janine's got men crawling all over. She's got three men holding on her at all times tonight. Like, oh my gosh, she's maybe we're all going splits on her. You know, like, it's cheaper that way per hour.
Get in.
Elevator, turn around. This is Gromit taking an elevator to the penthouse.
The penthouse.
This is kind of like a private box, you know. Like, Is anybody going to push the button?
Okay.
Yeah, push the button.
It'll be ice and odd.
Odd. We're several odd people. Although we should go to the ice level. Although the floor is going to turn and take it down.
Oops.
Across the back.
Sudden halt.
So now Janine's got two dates. She's got men all over her. This is like a fantasy for you, all these men around. Well, I'm stuck here.
Present thy elbows.
Okay, Gromit. Go, Gromit. Apparently, we got to walk all the way around. Okay, so now Gromit's in charge of like three blind guys. Look, careful on your right. Gotta find me a spot, Gromit. Everybody else is on their own. Bum, bum, bum. Sorry, sir. Three blind mice. I'm not used to this. Okay, maybe a spot in front of me. Go, Gromit. Let's see, Gromit. Find me a spot. Nice job, dog. This is why you get paid. The urinal's right in front of me, and there might be one to my right or left.
That's the sink over there to my left. Oh, there it is.
Yep. There's one right there. To help each other, opium blind, show each other where it is. There's a sink. It'd be nice if there's some standardization to where you can find soap, but I don't know, you get enough blind guys, you can figure it out. The thing I hate about those things is that when they're on, I can't hear anything. Okay, Gronk, go find the door out. You want to hold on to me, Mike, or? Not, I don't think it's a good idea, but I'm just saying if you want to. Okay, Gronk, go find the door out. Do, 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 do. Turn it left, and it looks like we're out of door. But where's that door? Gromit, go for it. Uh-oh. See, he's smart. Stays back to the door. Thank you. Okay, Gromit, go. Yep. Oh, I will. It's got to figure out which way it goes. No, I got my phone in my hand. I shouldn't do that. That's my bad. Gromit jumps out the door. I happen to hear a bar over there. Da-da-da. For future reference. That's nice. Right to the bar. Left to the bathroom. Here we are coming down the tunnel. Gromit! Gromit! Oh, there's the stage over there to the left. Good thing we came nice and early. Yes.
And
yep.
We're coming around.
Around and then really on the right.
And up the stairs we go.
Go, Gromit. Up. Up the stairs, Gromit. How far up? 2, 3, 7. 8, 9, 10. I guess we're on this level.
Come on. One down.
Gromit, back. Gromit wants his own row. He doesn't want to be associated with you guys. Gromit, go. Back up, down. Look at the view from up here. Go, Leaves, go. Go, Leaves, go. Okay, Gromit, down. Go. 1, 2. Here. Fuck. Okay, that was the third one. Yeah, always careful. Good advice. Okay, go. Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, everybody involved. Gromit settling in. I think he's getting the idea that this could be interesting. Looking around to see what's going on. It is 4:45, and it's not as busy as I thought it would be here. I imagine there's big lineups outside, so it's good thing we got in here, got settled in with my Coors Light at 9.75 a tall boy. Doesn't leave much room for a tip, you know, you put down 20 bucks and I was anticipating to leave that. Now if it was 16 bucks, I would have left $4 in tip, but it's more money for whoever, Labatt or Molson, and less for the employees. I guess that's the way it's going to go these days.
You guys are horrible dates for Janine. You guys use her to get in here and then you don't even talk to her. Mike's not even listening.
Apparently, he holds a Guinness World Record for Insanity Tour, 1,900,000 and some odd thousand tickets on that tour. That's a lot of tickets. That's a good goal for me. And I'm going to have to go to a lot of divey bars to sell 2 million tickets. But that's my new goal, see if I can outsell Jeff Dunnum on a tour. Just going to do a little shot of the row here. So you got myself, Shannon, Michael, and Rod in line, waiting with full anticipation of this show. It's going to start in like 5 minutes, but it's not as full as I would have expected. I would have thought there'd be a lot more energy, but this place is huge.
It holds like 7,000 people at capacity. I don't know, it could be 2,000 or 3,000 people here. And it was full for Russell Peters. That was amazing. And Tom O'Donnell was on stage. Did a great job. Surprisingly, the only time I've ever seen him perform sober.
5:06.
Show is supposed to start at 5 o'clock, but I expect the puppets are out back there doing cocaine or something, you know, doing shots and hanging out with strippers. So, you know, it's going to be a while to get this party started.
That just sounds creepy, like doll music. Chucky. Something's going on. Don't be a dumbass. Here's Jeff Dunnum.
Don't forget the words to their favorite song. Bubba J can.
Hey, is that Freedom Rock? Well then turn it up. Oh, too loud, turn it down.
That's right. Bubba J messes up your favorite songs from the comfort of his own garage. Who can resist current pop hits like...
Does my pink toe is sticking out of a sock hole? I haven't showered, so my foot is a stinko. What worries that my amigo?
Oh, man. Oh, hey, God. Down.
It's
back.
Just like being stuck in the car on a long trip with Bubba J and no radio.
Close down. Down, down. He's got his chin on the back of that seat. Now I wonder if he's going to be sneaking in some kind of food.
Bubba J does my brother. He's just a girl whom I could still have a dog. But the chair is not my son.
It's like going to karaoke night with Bubba J over and over. Holy, he never gets better.
And I think I like to look at your behind. Shouldn't do the thing that makes me blind. If it's something I should do alone. Oh no, no, no. That's a rocket in my bed.
And it ain't just rock and roll that Bubba J screws up.
King of the world.
Oh, Lord, your lines are too long. I'll stay home and shop on Amazon. I'm king of the world.
Hadn't had enough. Bubba J also kills the classics.
Goodbye, normal jeans. Though I never felt weird at all. I know I'm inbred cause Mama done slept with Uncle Paul. And it seemed to me that you lived your life screwing all our next of kin. Never knowing who to cling to when the test came in.
It's just like being stuck in hell with a singing Bubba J that won't stop.
Pictured herself getting pizza delivered with pepperoni and an order of fries. Her tummy rumbles, feeling quite empty. The girl with colitis eats pie. Makes your spine, it'll make you whine. He knows cut a tee, check his hands on feet. This is hard. I'm starting to hate Jackie Chan. Hello, darkness, my old friend. I come to talk with you again. Within the sounds of silence, I
commercial. Act now while supplies last. Available on 2 LPs, 4 cassettes, 3 CDs, or 1 8-track tape. Here's how to order. Call my cousin's cell phone because they repossessed mine. I'll also stay on your couch till I get sober. So we'll order now.
Opening for himself. He's his own hype guy. You don't have to share the profit. Not yet. He may never come. Crowd, I gotta turn this off now and enjoy the show.
How you doing, Kitchener? Well, thanks for coming out to the community. It was good to be in your fair city. I left Los Angeles a couple days ago. 72 degrees Fahrenheit. What the hell happened?
It was 72 here last week.
Well, it's good to be here. And by the way, a comedian always lives on what's going on in the world and what's happening. And as a comedian, I just got the best news 3 days ago. For what's
President
happening,
Trump.
And
Trump.
That is, I'm going to have 2 more years of work because Donald Trump is running again, so there you go. That's just information, we don't care, right? All right, again, thanks for coming out, and it is good to be back, and I don't know, for those of you who know who I was and were applauding for me, thank you for that, thank you very much, appreciate it, thank you.
Who I was.
Thank you. My show, don't know who I am, or were dragged here by family and friends, you think those people were applauding for me. That's fake news. They're applauding for those little people right there in the boxes, am I right? Yes? So, guess what that makes me? The opening act. They want my autograph, they want to take selfies. Are people scared of you?
Oh, yes they are.
So you're saying it's good being Ahmed the Dead Terrorist? No, they think I'm Nancy Pelosi.
I really think that was ad-libbed. He said he ad-libbed himself into a corner and he got himself out of that corner. This guy's a genius.
Well, that's got to be one of the creepiest, greatest things that happened during my show.
I want to have Jose in the show because he's Mexican.
No, that's what you said.
Looks like you want to make your show more white. What happened to diversity?
This is nuts.
Oh, those again.
Peanuts? Who put you in charge of HR?
You did. I did not. See how crazy you are? They're coming to take you away. Mr. Soup?
Mr. Soup.
And crackers.
I got it. So which of the guys has complained about me?
Walter.
Really?
Yeah, and they can do all those wise jokes which are very misogynistic.
No, he does the jokes.
I think we all know that's bullshit.
I don't even know where to point
this. And look at Bubba J.
What about Bubba J?
You make him look stupid.
That's because he is stupid.
And that's how you describe one of your dedicated employees.
Talking about the HR department, they were going to fire
how
him.
How should I describe Bubba J?
An intellectually deficient American.
I'm going to fire Jeff Dunnum.
You know,
he no longer fits the morals of the company.
If I were as stupid as Bubba J, I'd be protesting outside your show right now. Then I'd probably get drunk, forget what I was doing, and hire a hooker. This is ridiculous. You don't like me right now, do you?
No, I don't.
It's because I'm purple, isn't it?
No, it's because you're annoying.
Oh my gosh.
What?
You made me the token purple guy. I don't care what color anyone is. I bet you'd be upset if your wife gave birth to a kid who was the color of me. Admit it.
I would be upset, yes, but thankfully that would never happen.
Just wait, pal. Once chicks go lavender, they want me like a scavenger. Oh yeah,
that's the fourth or fifth wraparound.
His pronouns are dill, sweet, gherkin, and kosher.
Pronouns, dill, sweet, kosher.
And your adjective is asshole.
That's nice.
So now Jose is officially from North America.
No, he's not.
No, I'm not.
See?
See? No. I came here on a bus from Martha's Vineyard.
No longer from Mexico. Not to offend the Mexicans.
This is nuts.
Jeff likes to talk about his nuts. Maybe they are hot nuts. On a stick. Well, there's a visual.
You know, you can't do this to him.
Get any closer and I'll report your nuts. Hot nuts. So, Jose, actually, senor, if I'm no longer a jalapeno on the steak, then you can call me Joe. Joe. Joe the tickle. The hot tickle,
right,
on the steak.
Okay.
Senor Jeff, yes, I just thought of something.
What's that?
Including Senor Peanut, you now have three nuts.
Hey!
Now that he is getting angry,
yeah?
You have three hot nuts.
What the hell?
Not on the steak. So, you are steakless. What? I said you are steakless. I'm okay not having a steak. Is that what your girlfriend told you?
Hey!
Timothy F? Dear Peanut, what's the best way to propose to your girlfriend using a bridge?
Well, if she says no, just jump.
Whoa!
That'll tease the bitch.
Archie Langford?
He just advocates suicide.
Oh no, dear Peanut, boy. Should proofread a little better. Dear Peanut, what would you tell a teacher that wants to retire but can't afford it?
Oh.
I hope you learned something.
Can't afford $100,000.
Well, I knew you were going to hell, so I thought I'd hitch a ride. I guess.
John Simmons, dear Peanut, are children with peanut allergies allowed to play with you?
Oh, ha, ha, ha. Yes, they are. Deal with the itch, bitch.
By the way, when the show's not over, it's not quite over. I have a gun here to shoot up some peanut dolls, so just hang on real quick. Just take a couple minutes or two. There we go. Susan M, dear Peanut, why does my boyfriend love his Jeep more than me?
Bigger headlights.
Oh. John McClendon, dear Peanut, after 20 plus years of marriage, how can I get my wife to, you know, want to, you know, have, well, you know, sex? Any thoughts?
Well, John, clearly from this question, it shows you like to beat around the bush. Therein lies the problem.
Anita Mandalay?
Oh, wow. That's a point.
I don't know.
I still don't get it.
Howard Franklin?
These guys are quick.
Oh, dear Pina, do you have any advice for someone married for 55 years? That's great. It's okay, Howard. It's almost over. Austin Fulton? Dear Peanut, how can I be as funny as you? Come on up, bend over. Dr. Dunnum will see you momentarily. Stacy Ryan? Dear Peanut, do you feel safe at home with Jeff? Blink twice if you need help.
Son of a bitch! You guys made an awesome audience. Thanks for coming out today. We'll see you next time.
I don't know if there's a recording, but that was hilarious. That was funny. That was intelligent. That was a genius. That was remarkable. That was amazing. That was everything. Awesome. Absolutely awesome.
Yeah.
Thank you, Jeff.
Oh, yeah. All right, let's get the bigger gun out here right now. Let's get the big gun. Right, there you are. We're waiting for the big gun to come out. Here we go. There's you guys right there.
Thank you, Jeff. So inspirational for an up-and-coming wannabe, never-gonna-be a comic. I'd love to fill this place, but I don't have this kind of mentality. I got a dog that I can make talk. I'm going to take his lessons. I'm gonna take vantriloquist tech lessons and make Gromit talk. JeffDunnum.com. You can learn to make other things talk.
I need a target. There it is. Here we go. You guys got it. Coming out. We'll see you next time. Good night.
And that's 4 beers done. Thank you, Mr. Dunnum. God, that was amazing.
Hey, so you had something you wanted to share with the class.
Not at all.
Not at all. See, all of a sudden the camera comes on, everybody's shy.
Absolutely.
So, you enjoy the show?
Most of it.
Every other word?
No.
He's also hearing impaired, so me talking and laughing probably interrupted.
No.
Would you like your money back?
It
did come with a money back guarantee.
It was worth every penny I paid. Absolutely, no doubt about that.
So it was for nothing.
So I guess for the audience out there, I should say that Mike wasn't my first choice as a date for my girlfriend. Yeah. Nor was Rod my second choice as a date for my girlfriend.
No.
No. I think she could afford better, really.
Yeah.
I can afford.
But it was good, right? It was fun. It was worth coming out.
I thought Bubba J was the funniest tonight. And usually I think it's Walter, but tonight I thought it was Bubba J.
Bubba J, hands down. I don't know. I thought Jeff Dunnum was the funniest myself. And
yeah.
He's got some really intelligent stuff and really smart. And he really flirted with a lot of material that's sensitive. And he handled it great right off the hop. And he said, although he did say, though, that if you tell a joke to 100 people and 2 people get offended, then the problem's with the 2 people.
Exactly.
And I'm like, you know what? I think you should have followed that up and said, everybody can take a turn and be that 2 people. And you can be offended and still join the group. You don't have to leave. Everybody's inclusive. You're all welcome to be offended.
Yeah.
Yeah. I thought he did a great job. Thanks, Jeff. It was a pleasure to meet you, although I never did. But I do hope to learn how to make Gromit talk. Although I have always said if this dog starts talking, I'd have to kill him.
Yeah.
That's it for us at Jeff Dunnum's show. Did you have a good time, Gromit? What'd you think? Turns away, it's like snack, I wanna go pee.